Hey, what's up, y'all? Jeremy here. Check this out. This is my last invitation for you to join the waitlist for our 2024 Next Level Speakers Conference. 2021 was amazing. 2022 was epic. 23 was mind-blowing. But 2024, like everything, we're going to a whole nother level. And for those of you all that joined our exclusive waitlist, you're going to get a discounted price even less than early bird. So you want to register, right? This is going to be the number one event for speakers, whether you want to be a professional speaker, a motivational speaker, corporate trainer, workshop facilitator, or you want to be branded as a thought leader. This conference is for you. The energy and vibe is going to be unmatched. And there is something very special for you in store right here in Atlanta, Georgia, June 7th through 9th for the Next Level Speakers Conference. Join the waiting list and I'll see you there.
It's not just backward. Yeah. If it's not forward, it's a problem. Period. Yeah, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, if it's wrong forward.
Bruh, you could be going this way. And I'm talking about if you just, and that's what's so deep about your senses. If you just look, your body now follows where you're going. You see what I'm saying? If you just look.
Yeah.
So I'm saying be careful with that, because any other direction is not where you're trying to go.
You ready? All right.
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the Bayesian sensation, Mr. Carl Wesley Phillips.
What's going on, y'all? What it do?
Dr. King in the building. Dr. King, what's happening?
What's up, my brother? I'm good, man.
How you feeling?
I'm wonderful.
I got Douglas.
I'm working on, I'm trying to, give me a second. I'm trying
to. Listen, this is Lord. It's tight times right now. And I met the criteria. So we shall see. How's everybody feeling?
Blessed, man.
Carl, you're about to say something before I...
Oh, no, I was going to say I prayed after our last podcast. We was talking about it just now. I prayed different last night because Maul said some stuff on our last podcast. I was like, no, God, here's the dollar amount. I wasn't specific. I wasn't specific before. I talked about growing and increasing, but I was like, no, this is the dollar amount that I was talking about.
So. Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks for teaching me how to pray a little better, Mom.
Oh, bro, I don't remember that part of the podcast, but you know what I'm saying? But hey, let's go.
You got him on the line?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm going back and forth with him right now.
Okay, what did he say? He gonna do something?
He didn't respond yet. It was 2 seconds ago. But I got you.
You said back and forth.
Yeah, meaning, meaning that I'm believing. Once I hit send,
because
I did it at 8:15, I'm 8:15. Not mad. Yeah, he coming back. I'm speaking in faith, Ma.
I'm with you.
He already in the future.
Yeah. I'm with you.
Yeah, he already been. We already know that he in the future.
Podcast.
No. We're at a crossroads this second. Y'all will find out soon. So my 360 status with Delta is in limbo. Which is. Never a good place to be. I mean, I passed Diamond last year, and it felt good to be 360. I'm not going to lie.
No, for sure. I've seen the benefits.
Maul seen the benefits.
I've seen it.
What's the benefits?
They treat this man. We went into the Sky Lounge one time.
Uh-huh. Tell the truth.
And they just was like, you know, they normally is like, hey, how you doing? Yeah. They look down. This is the first time he didn't even know he had it. They look down. Looked up at CJ. Looked back down. Looked back up and was like, sir. Called him sir.
Yeah.
She said, you're 360.
Yeah.
I don't even think you knew what that meant.
It was early.
He was like, what? What?
It was MVP and didn't even know.
He didn't even know, dog.
The MVP.
I mean, her whole demeanor changed. She looked at him like, yo, like he's an anomaly. She's just like, yo, you 360.
Yeah, 360.
I'm talking about people be cheering.
Was you with me when the lady was like?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
She was like.
Yes, she hit him just like that. I'm over here like, what is going on?
Yeah,
can
bro.
You do something?
It's a different
180, can you do something for
bro. It's a whole
180, can
I'm
you do something
for it got
for
Diamond looking like poverty, bro.
Yeah, it's different.
Poverty, bro. I'm like, come on, bro. So
he been
anyway.
To the mountaintop.
Yeah.
So long story short, a few of my 360 brethren have received their confirmation email for their 2024 status. And, Yeah, well, we working on, we back channeling now.
Back channeling.
Is that how you guys got on the runway too? How y'all just pulled up with the car on the runway?
Yeah,
They had I'm still learning.
Didi be pissed. She like, why he ain't never using it? I was like, we don't got nowhere to go.
I only used it one time, honestly.
Yeah.
I only used it one time.
When the flight's tight.
Yeah.
I've never used it.
They picked me and Nick up when I took Nick to New York.
So you didn't use it, though. They did it for you.
No, they did it for me. I didn't even
know. That's what I'm saying.
I never even knew you could request it. I thought they just look at, they track your flight. So the one time it happened, we landed, it's crazy, because we landed in Detroit and had a connection to Grand Rapids. It was coming back from New York, like JFK or something. We landed in Detroit, had a connection to make our flight to go to Grand Rapids, and it was tight. And I didn't even know. I was just told Nick, like, hey, when we get off this plane, we got to boogie over to the gate. We only got about, you know, 22, 23 minutes. And, of course, we were in Detroit and landed in B gates. Flight was in A. Mm-hmm. You know, you like, oh, come on. Whew. So as soon as I got off, Nick was actually sitting ahead of me. So he got off and was standing next to a dude. I thought he was just waiting for me to get off the plane at the jet bridge. And dude had my name on the iPad and was like, let's go. Whoop, dropped down, got in the Porsche, took straight over to the joint and made walked straight on the plane, bro. Straight on the plane.
360, can you do something?
Can you do that was the only time I got to use it.
360.
Now, I'm going to say this. It probably would be more beneficial for somebody who didn't live in Atlanta.
In Atlanta, right.
Because I live in Atlanta, it's
all
straight
flights
everywhere.
Home,
I rarely ever have a connection. So, you know what I'm saying? Bro,
we got you, Mark.
I promise you, bro, I probably had maybe two connections like domestically all year. Like it go everywhere straight. Yeah. So you don't really use it as much. But if I can imagine if you 360 and you live in a place that's not a hub, you probably gonna use that a lot.
This is a lesson. A lot of us have access, whether it be God or other people, and we're not using it. I've never done three, like Diddy said this last time, like we was on a train and got stuck. She's like, yo, 360 could have took us to the car rental place. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got stuck for no reason. She's like, we could have just got in 360 and went, let them take us there, and we could have been. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna start using it more. Not just 360, just period. Mm-hmm. Like, I even have, what do they call it? Like, you know, when you buy maintenance for different things in the house, like, I don't always... I don't call.
Yeah.
Like, bro, I paid for my man to come.
Yeah.
I'm wanting them to service me because I'm like, y'all, I paid, so y'all should just know, come, but they don't always come.
Yeah.
So it's like, nope, I need to start. Hey, bro, I paid for the service.
Yep.
I'm going to need you to come.
Because they warranties. They know you're not going to pay.
Yeah, that's one of the things.
It's like, they know you're not. Yeah. It's like gym memberships. They make you have to send a letter to cancel your membership.
Yeah.
I didn't have to send a letter to start my membership. Why I got to send a letter to cancel? Because they know you're not going to do it.
Exactly. Oh, bro, you ever try to cancel? Like, bro.
Anything. It's like mafia.
They be like, literally, press one, talk to nobody.
Yeah, to nobody.
Press two to speak to nobody.
No, back in the day, it was more like mafia. Now, because of technology, you just can't even get nobody.
Well, they don't. I'm saying most companies don't have customer service. Nah. Like, it's an email now. Ain't nobody answering no
phone.
They
be
like
we can help you with everything right here. Cap. Bro, ain't nothing going to get me to cussing and hollering like being on the phone with them jokers. I be like, bro, it's unholy, bro.
I just don't like the energy that they put in the beginning and it ain't none on the back
end.
But the front end, when they taking my loot,
that
Caddy had me in like a little escort. They only had escorts at Cadillac.
Wow.
And my Joker got broke.
Right.
Bro, I'm like, Mike was like, E, you good? I was like, what happened? So you got that granny car out there. What you doing in granny's car? I was like,
dang.
Oh. He's like, what happened to the Escalade? I'm like, about that. It broke down, and they gonna tell me when I got there they ain't had nothing.
Hey, I was going back to what you said before. I remember Jesse Itzler. He was talking about the opposite of what you said in terms of, remember his story? He's like, I'm taking access from anything, whether I got it or not.
Yeah.
So you got some people that live like, yo, if you give me a smidgen of access, I'm running through that joker. And then you got others that's just like, I'm not so
passive,
sure.
Passive, timid body. No, I realize, man, in this world, bruh, you timid, bruh. They gonna eat you alive, bro. Like they prey on that. Like if you, yes sir, yes man, like any you know consideration, they gonna run over you. And I don't, you know, I'm not the person that like believes always in being demanding, but I'm like, that needs to be your, what do they call that? Like when it's something that's automatic, like your default. Yeah, so sometimes Jada literally cussed a white male out, older white male out in the store because she was in line and he just cut in front of her. And so she went off. And I was like, Jada, you know, would he have anybody? Like, yeah, his son, whatever. And I was like, what? But then I was like, you know what? Let me back off because if you're nice, that he felt like he entitled.
Yeah.
So even though you was in line, he just felt like he could just jump in front of you.
Yeah.
And just ain't nothing you could do about it. So I was like, you know what, Jada? I would normally teach you to whatever, but I'm like, nah. And you a female?
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, you got to be aggressive.
Yep.
And I trust you not just out here going off and whatever. So
right.
When you do feel that, like, you have to be strong.
It's necessary.
Yeah, go ahead. Bro, you got
to
do
it. It's a 5-minute clip I'm not going to show you. I mean, I'll text it to y'all, but this dude, and this is like something that happened in Europe. But a dude went to his next door neighbor, knocked on the door, and was like, bruh, I need you to, whatever you did, like, undo it because I can't access the Wi-Fi no more. My man was like, what? He's like, yeah, like, I've been using the Wi-Fi, and I don't know what happened. Okay. I don't know, but he ain't saying it like that. He's like, y'all been using the Wi-Fi, and I don't know what happened, but I can't access it. It's asking me for a password. And dude was like, yeah, I put a password on my stuff because I've noticed that mine has been slowing down,
right.
And I had it open. You talk about entitled. My dude was like, yo.
Because you over there.
Literally.
On the hub.
No, my man says, but you can't do that.
I got it.
My man says, but you can't do that. Like, yo, like, I've been using it for 2 years. You can't just shut it off like that. Dude was like, wait, are you serious? You at my door telling me, like, I can't. The dude was like, yo, I paid for this. My man said to him, talk about entitled. I was like, yo, this is like a joke. Dude was like, no. You pay for what's inside your house. What comes outside is free. It's in the public. Bro, I'm just showing you mindset. Dude, and not on cap. He's literally arguing with my man, like beating his door down, like, bruh, how you gonna put a password on our Wi-Fi?
Hey, bro, that's exactly how I felt when they stopped my Netflix account from CJ's. I was like, yo, what the heck is going on?
Wow, you too. We didn't get 360.
I used to click on the Queenie.
Let me tell you something.
Not no more.
Let me tell you, some kind of way Douglas still got it. I seen the login the other day. Everywhere I know, that's how I know where he at all the time. Syracuse.
No, I'm gonna tell you this. It did me like that, Maul. And I went and knocked on the door.
No.
I was like, see, what's up, bro? She was like, well, I ain't do that. I was like, okay, cool. Long as you didn't do it.
Right. Yeah, no, you know what? Bro, I'm gonna be real. I don't watch Netflix.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I feel like everything, we watch stuff on Prime, we'll watch like Hulu or something. I don't ever really have nothing on Netflix.
Netflix is that thing, though, that once or twice a year,
you'll find a
they
show.
Come out
find
something with.
Yeah. What do you watch?
I'm going to tell you what I watch.
Are you hydrating every day? Well, our friends at Organifi, they believe in hydration with purpose. Introducing their superfood powder blends that turn your everyday water into a delicious, nutrient-packed drink. It's like a power boost from nature. One standout is their green juice, a personal favorite of ours for years. Unlike other green juices, it actually tastes great. Imagine enjoying a refreshing drink that's better than plain water and filled with incredible ingredients like chlorella, spirulina, and moringa from around the world. Just one scoop a day can make a massive difference for your body. What sets Organifi apart is the clinical dose of the adaptogen ashwagandha, known to balance cortisol levels, your stress hormone. In times of heightened stress, this can be a game changer for your weight, sleep, and your immune system. Organifi sources top quality ingredients from organic farms worldwide, ensuring their products are vegan friendly, gluten free, and free of any artificial additives. It's pure nutrition in every sip. All right, so here's the exciting part for you. Because you rock with the Secrets to Success podcast, you can go to Organifi.com/success and explore their collection. And at checkout, make sure you use the promo code SUCCESS for an exclusive 20% discount on all products. Yes, you heard it right. It's VIP treatment just for you. Discover how these superfoods can transform your health journey. Visit Organifi.com/success and use the promo code SUCCESS at checkout and experience it for yourself. Your satisfaction is guaranteed. Hydrate with purpose and elevate your well-being with Organifi Green Juice. Cheers to a healthier you.
Because all the other ones, it's weird that you can't really find, like, on Hulu something that's like, you know, non-sexual or whatever.
Oh yeah, that's Netflix. Why I ain't finding him. Yeah. I'm looking for the sexual.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying. Netflix has a bunch of British-based shows.
Yeah, that's
they got yeah. It's good stuff. It's their acting is good. It's just it is a seem a little B plushes, but
yeah,
it's just,
don't nobody want to watch no B.
I'm telling you though, like if you do America, they like violence, sexual, so and so, so and so. When you do,
but they ain't got no real sex stuff on Netflix.
Yeah, okay, but when you do the British, it goes smoking. Mm. They got smoking on that joint.
Oh, like
cussing. That'd be the two things: smoking and cussing.
They it's do like, do okay. cigarettes
what
over
is,
there.
What does Tubi have?
You know, Tubi is.
I ain't never seen Tubi. I
don't look at it.
Bro, Tubi is like we just shoot a movie right
they said,
now.
And they said a lot of Detroit.
Oh, they bro, a lot of Detroit. Out there with their cell phone.
I never watched a Tubi movie, but I've seen it.
Oh, you Tubi not on all the stuff now. They promoting it big.
Yeah. No. Yeah, on your smart TV.
Everything.
Yeah, it's already downloaded.
People
there.
Be getting shot.
I'm saying like when
they
you
fall
on Hulu,
down 3 minutes later.
When you on Hulu, you'll see a commercial for it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they got commercials. Like they make it. Somebody got bread. They got a lot of commercials now.
Really?
Yeah. Well, yeah. His Netflix. Yeah. They just you can't watch. You can't do. I'm like, yeah.
Hey, real quick. Somebody asked me to bring back the Fair File, so I wanted to bring it back. I'm not exactly sure how me and one of my homies got on this topic, but I think I said something along the lines of, so Trey is like 10 now. So his mom, my wife, will say like, you know, always tell the kids, go get your pajamas on. So Trey is huge, one. And then I was like, bruh, you know, I told my wife like, hey, pajamas is dead. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, go put your basketball shorts on, your t-shirt. We in that phase. Oh, like, sure. Ain't no.
Yeah.
And I was telling my homie that, and he was like.
Back and forth, by the way.
Oh,
back
God.
And forth.
Oh, that's a nice little paragraph he wrote, too.
I got you.
Yeah, okay, come on.
Like instruction.
On. On it. Yeah.
Hey, so my homie was like, oh, why you telling him that? I said, bro, he, like, you know, when you. Get a little old, you know, Spider-Man and Superman, that's dead. Like, just go on and put your, he was like, you don't wear pajamas? And I was like, no, I don't. Yeah. He was like, I said, you do? He said, I wear pajamas every night.
Wow.
That's... And then I got to thinking, I was like, dang, when I used to watch like Fresh Prince back in the day.
Yeah, they did.
All the dads, you would see them wearing like pajamas at some point. Yeah. And I was like, okay, maybe
except for
I'm
good times.
Tweaking.
JJ had on the onesie,
but the father always had the same.
Never went to sleep.
The father had.
He was working.
Yeah, he was working.
Bro,
he worked three shifts.
Bro, he literally wore the same pants every episode. Go watch it.
Them khakis.
Wait.
But it was khaki corduroy.
Yep, khaki corduroy. Oh, wow. Sean did.
Yeah,
he did with the plaid shirt.
Every single episode.
Wow.
Bro. Wow.
Yeah. Consistent. JJ was the only one that really switched up.
Yeah.
Like that. Yeah.
So, I know. I already know. Maul might be wearing pajamas. Maul seems like a pajama guy. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I don't wear pajamas.
Okay. All right. I was just asking because my homie was like, oh, I wear pajamas every night.
Yeah. No, I don't wear pajamas.
He like, I was like,
what's the point? Why would I work out this hard to wear pajamas to bed? Bro, I'm trying to show my muscles off at night.
That's what I told my wife because she was like, oh, okay. Like, I'm like, he done. So, he don't wear pajamas no more. And my homie was literally like, I was like, so every night he was like, yeah, I go, when out there, I get out the shower, I was like, a robe? And he was like, nah, pajamas.
Now, I ain't gonna lie.
And I was like, do they got Scooby-Doo on them? Like, what is you doing,
I
my
do
boy?
Wear a robe in Cali.
A robe is cool. I don't have no problem with a robe.
I don't wear a robe, but. I don't have
but
a
you
robe
you don't wear
here.
It in bed.
No, Cali, I don't know. Like, it's something about going in the backyard.
And your robe.
With the robe and then getting the hot tub. Getting the hot tub. So it's like a resort. You know how when
wait.
I love it. Oh,
no,
side.
Oh, no.
He, that's that left side mentality.
Yeah.
I love
I'm
it.
Saying, you know, when we in Dubai, they give us a robe.
Yeah.
And then you go to the hot tub.
Hey, that's I'm going to send you some cigars soon. I can see it coming.
Yeah,
I can see it coming.
You ain't got to light it. You just hold it in your mouth.
Okay, because I didn't know it was good. Okay.
So, wait. So you doing the robe?
Yeah. What? In the Cali though, not here in Michigan.
Yeah.
I don't got nothing to put a robe on it. Next door, I don't really got nothing.
Well, you upgraded the crib. You go ahead, a little roll back.
That's the kitchen. There's no, I wear my shorts in the kitchen.
Yeah, okay, got you.
I'm wearing shorts, boxers, something like that to sleep in.
In the shorts. Okay, I thought I was
when tripping. When did you stop wearing pajamas, Ma?
Seven.
I don't even know. Yeah, I can't remember.
Saying Barbados.
My parents never told me to go put my pajamas on.
Really?
Like, there's some new stuff.
My wife
never said that.
My daughter is kind of like, okay, put your pajamas. Like, I get it, maybe. But like my son, like Trey, I used to be looking like,
go to bed.
Yeah, I think
okay,
Jada
first of all,
might,
they don't even make pajamas in your size no more, big dog. Yeah. Like them PJs you got on is from when you was like 7 or 8. But I mean, he don't wear them no more. But I just was like, yo, at some point as a little boy, you just transition to hoop shorts.
Yeah, that's all
like
I wear.
T-shirt.
Bro, we was in underwear. Like, my parents said, go
I'm
to
saying,
bed.
Or underwear, yeah.
It was just go underwear. To bed. Yeah.
I'm saying, yo, go put your pajamas on.
I'm saying, but my kids will shower first and then come back down. We'll have our prayer time, quiet time, stuff like that. So, like, you coming out the shower, you ain't going to put your clothes back on. So, you got to put something on. And then Avery was sleeping in her pajamas. But Trey, I was like, bruh. Like, and he might just have shorts and just no shirt. You know what I'm saying? Just shorts. But I'm like, yeah, my homie was like, I'm like, PJs. Like a full set.
Was he from urban community?
No.
Okay, all right. All right. Makes sense. Nah, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, I say like, maybe like a Lansing, you know?
Yeah.
Not like urban, like he ain't from the city and nothing.
Yeah.
So anyway, I thought that was crazy. Real quick, not sure if you can get a zoom in on the feet, Korshawn. You know what I'm saying? Quick announcement. You know what I'm saying? These are the legendary Sean Kemps for those of y'all listening. I want to give a congratulations to all of us. Our first sneaker deal is officially in the book.
And I kind of, I didn't know what those were, but I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, these.
Yeah, I felt a connection to them. I didn't know why.
No.
I was like, I can rock those because you had some other ones. I was like, oh, no, I can't.
Those are just the classics.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I had on the classics.
Okay.
Yeah, we're not getting paid.
What that
to wear
say
those.
At the end of those? What, at the bottom of them all? Oh, Jordan. Okay, I didn't know what it said. Okay.
First deal. Obviously, Toby. You know, Reebok. Man, we was working on this for like seemed like a year.
Yeah, I almost thought.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. So it's done now. So salute.
Your 360 almost done too.
Oh, come on. Come on, Douglas. Can you do something?
Hey, fair foul. Are they gonna just act like we ain't sitting here?
I was gonna ask you, should we say something? Because he said be demanding.
You know what I'm saying? I'm about to be demanding.
Well, you gotta be at least like platinum.
We can't go from silver
to 360.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, the man ain't Jesus.
I'm just saying.
Can we get platinum?
We over here like we ain't here.
Hey, can we get diamond?
Come on, bro.
Can we get something?
You gotta get to.
Can I just get the diamond?
Right.
I mean, I could ask.
You know what I'm saying? Wait.
Slow down. Don't see that when you. That's when he.
I'll wait till the 360.
Yeah, please. Wait till it hit my phone, bro.
See how he is though.
Wait till it hit my phone.
I'll wait for the 360,
bro. You be flying United and American, bro. I don't fly nothing but Delta.
I'm just saying, I gotta fly what's available.
I know. That's
it's
what
not by choice.
So you don't even need 360 because you don't fly Delta like
I didn't
that.
Say 360. I said, give me diamond.
Let's get diamond.
For what?
So I don't get stuck in another country again like I did last time. Just freaking.
You
this guy left me, E. Fair fine. He left me with his little 360 diamond. CJ and Candace was like this. We was all together. CJ said, man, blood couldn't make us no closer.
But
bro,
Delta,
the second
flight could depart.
The second we was.
It could separate.
The second we was in. Where was we? Rome?
Yeah.
We in Rome and it was crazy and they were like, the flights, we can't take everybody.
Yeah.
You're losing your first class. If you want to go, you have to. CJ was like,
nah, I got it.
He said, this is where we part. He was like, Candace,
what the blood turned to?
Oh, bro, blood turned to water. He said, Candace, come on. And they left and they over there, Diamond, please. They called their names. They was like, they did call your name, didn't they? Tell the truth.
Is Carlos here?
They was like, I'm like this. Me and Camille like this. Like, we with them. They were like, no, sir.
Yeah.
Go up in the back of the plane. Oh.
That blood was thin.
Oh, that blood was thin. He took a blood thinner.
Anemic.
That day.
Anemic.
A blood thinner.
Did you make it home?
My back was messed up.
Did you make it
they
home?
They had me sit next to some lady talking about Kanosaki.
Bruh, did you make it home?
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Put me in the hospital, bruh. I had to go see Gersh.
Man, that was.
They had me riding coach, bro. Man.
Yeah, no.
Oh, bro, long flight, man. That I paid for first class.
You know what?
I get your money back.
You know, that's another story. Okay. They said they did.
They're going to give you miles.
We couldn't find. Yeah, there was a lot of deposits. They said we couldn't really. So I didn't have the time to go through it. I told Cam to go through it. I think she said the money came.
I ain't even had 360 that year. That was just
you
diamond.
Was diamond.
Yeah, but diamond is tough.
No, diamond is still. Diamond's tough. Top of the top, other than 360.
In another country. Tough. Hey, listen, man, it got to the point where I was like, look, Camille, I told my wife, I said, look, we ain't diamond when it comes to Delta, but we show, what is that called in Wakanda, man? Vibranium.
Oh, no.
Like, we vibranium in life. Yeah. I was like, we can sustain. He can tell you. Oh, yeah. I was like, bro, we went to the best spa.
Now tell the truth about what happened, because that ain't what happened.
That is what happened.
That is not what happened.
What didn't happen?
How you just told the story.
It literally happened.
Is this man telling you about the story?
It literally happened. Y'all was good. Of course, we weren't going to the same
story. Right. We weren't even on the same.
Somebody tell a story.
They said they called my name. We weren't even on the same plane.
But we was right there. Our gate was here. Your gate was here. We saw you and Candace go to the.
But you wasn't on our plane, though.
Of course, we wasn't on the plane. We was going back to Chicago. Y'all was going back to Atlanta. But I remember seeing y'all, and they was like, they called the Queenies, and y'all walked up. Y'all supposed to be in coach. And
yeah, then, we were because they messed up our flight.
And they called your name.
So this is what I was trying to tell Maul, right? So he's right. You could Maul stay in Rome for 2 weeks if you want. Bruh, it was right after COVID when the flights was going. Remember every flight. So we over there and they like, our first class gone. Nah, Delta, this ain't no slander. I'm just telling you what happened. You know what I'm saying? 360.
Don't let this episode go out until 360 is confirmed.
No, I'm just saying, this is what happened. So we over there.
You want to play nice.
So I was saying.
That 360.
So once we was over there, they basically hit us with an email like, your flight canceled. We rebooked you on this flight.
The night of, you in coach.
Which was crazy. We like, wait a minute. You just like, that flight canceled. You on this flight and you in
coach
97Z. Mm. Cool.
Mm. Not even an aisle seat. They put so us
I
was in the middle.
Like, so, you know, I'm calling for all of us. They like, yo, it's nothing. It's this flight only. Now, I'm looking at the flights. I'm looking at the flight the next day, booked up. I'm looking at all kind of stuff. I'm on the phone for 4 or 5 hours in the hotel room. So I told Marl and them, I'm about to just take the coach. I'm just going to take the L because I got to get back because I was trying to get Candace Tesla.
Right.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
So I was like, bruh. And Tesla told me. Bruh, if you don't pick it, they was already doing me a favor by keeping it up there. They was like, go ahead. If you miss this, we giving your car away. And Candace wanted this car bad. So I said, I'm going to take the L and get on and coach. So that's what happened. They said, I was like, hey, we was going to.
The fact that they called your name.
I'm saying, by this time, we taking two different flights.
Right.
They still called his name.
But you said, you act like I did anything.
But you see him.
Let's talk about magic. Not the abracadabra kind, but the kind that turns dreams into reality. We never imagined running an online store, selling merch or anything like that. Our goal was just to inspire the world. But now, thanks to Shopify, we're not just selling. We found a way to inspire the world through physical and digital products. Shopify is the global commerce platform that's got your back from launch day to your millionth order. Whether you're selling scented soap or stylish outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell everywhere in person and online. With the internet's best converting checkout, Shopify turns browsers into buyers 36% better than the rest. And now Shopify has joined the AI revolution to help you gain more with less effort using Shopify Magic. One of the things that I love about Shopify is how they continue to create more ways for us to make money. You don't have to sell just your own stuff anymore. With Shopify Collective, you can curate products to sell from other brands that you love, giving your customers more variety and your business more sales. And get this, you can also actually bundle products together. Shopify powers 10% of all e-commerce in the United States, and Shopify is the global force behind Allbirds, Rothy's, and Brooklinen, and millions of others across 175 countries. Plus, Shopify's award-winning help is there to support you every step of the way. Because businesses that grow, they grow with Shopify. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/secret-to-success, all lowercase. Again, shopify.com/secret-to-success, all words. Go there now to grow your business no matter what stage you're in. shopify.com/secret-to-success.
It's time to get real, guys. If you have a family like I do, then you need to get them life insurance to protect them. It's one of the smartest financial decisions that you can make. And the start of a new year is the perfect time to get it done, so you can focus on whatever else the year has in store for you. Fabric by Gerber Life was designed by parents for parents to help you get a high quality, surprisingly affordable term life insurance policy in less than 10 minutes. Fabric has flexible policies that fit your family and your budget, with quality policies like $1 million in coverage for less than $1 a day. It's all online and on your schedule. No appointments, no scheduling, or piles of paperwork. Just apply when it's convenient for you. You could go from start to covered in less than 10 minutes with no health exam required. There's no risk to apply, and they have a 30-day money-back guarantee, and you can cancel at any time. Fabric has partnered with Gerber Life, trusted by millions of families like yours, for over 50 years. With over 1,800 five-star reviews, they're rated as excellent on Trustpilot. And Fabric does more than just life insurance. It's a one-stop shop that also has free digital wills, investment accounts that let you save for your kids' future, and you can manage your family's finances right from your phone, so your family is prepared for anything. Join the thousands of parents who trust Fabric to protect their family. Apply today in just minutes at meetfabric.com/success. Again, that's meetfabric.com/success. MEET fabric.com/success. Policies issued by Western Southern Life Assurance Company, not available in certain states. Prices subject to underwriting and health questions.
You see her?
We on the podcast. That's why I couldn't answer.
Oh, Chuku.
Yeah.
Oh, Chuku. Yeah, come on, bro.
Yeah, we on the podcast right now.
That's Toby.
That's why I couldn't answer.
Live on the pod.
Right, he just made the announcement.
Come on.
He just made the announcement.
You dig?
Yeah, about his shoe deal.
That's
right.
And then
he said your name second.
Right.
That's right. Let him know, Chuku.
Yeah, is one of these cameras showing? There we go. Okay, all right. So I want him to know, he said he got a shoe deal, and then he mentioned your name second, Toe.
Right. Put him by the mic.
I said we.
What else was he doing?
Exactly. He said, what other way was he doing?
Well, he could have said, you got a shoe deal.
Yeah, no, that wouldn't be the truth.
That wouldn't be Carlos Quinney Jr. like.
Exactly.
Hey, he should name the shoe the Chuku's 360.
All right, I'm going to go into this gym, man.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so anyway, so then after we all agreed, and I told them, I was just like, bro.
Who was we?
We agreed what the plan was in terms of what we going on coach. And because we were supposed to all fly together on the flight to like Boston or something, and then we was going to fly to Atlanta and they was going to fly to Chicago.
Right, now, so we initially were supposed to fly together.
Yes.
All right.
And then they split it up.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Because they like, okay, you going, like, how it all ended up working out. I was just like, I'm going
to
take the L.
Well, they didn't split it up. You all saw that you can get a flight straight to Atlanta, I believe.
Didn't no, we didn't go straight
y'all
to
went
Atlanta.
To Boston.
We went to New York.
Well, right.
We went to New York.
We went to Chicago. No.
We went to New York.
That's we went what to I'm Boston.
Saying. Right. But I'm saying, so then after we, bro, my ticket said 72F, and then we got to the gate, and it was like, come on. And they put us right back up in first. That did happen.
We got
but this
to the
was
gate.
After.
The reverse of this
they
is.
They put you further back.
They told us, like, sir, I was snapping. They was like, sir, what we're going to do for you is we're going to give you a whole row.
I remember you talked about it.
They said, you're going to give you a whole row. You're going to be fine. You could stretch out, you and your wife. And I was like, really, a whole row? And I said, well, how many seats in a whole row? Is it two? They was like, no, it's four seats. We're going to give you a whole row.
That wasn't bad. That was going to be nice.
They said, and we're going to take care of you like first class. We're going to serve you. Mm. We're going to do all of these things for you, get a hot towel. Mm. And I was like, you know what? This might not be too bad. I get on that doggone plane. Bro, I get on that plane, E. I sit down, man, me and Camille. We ain't even sat down for 5 minutes. Bro, I saw some old lady come over there to his dog, and she's like, excuse me, sir. Excuse me. She said, you're in my seat. And I got my legs up. I said, no, 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 ma'am. I was like, they told me I get the whole row. I was supposed to be in that first class. They told me I get the whole row. And she said, oh, okay. And she had been about 85 years old. Then she walked off. Because I was like, I'm not getting up. She walked off, bro.
Duh,
went to the back of the plane.
That's a sicko.
Oh, bro. She
grandma, 85.
85, bro. She
didn't tell grandma. go somewhere else.
She come back,
go
bro.
Put your pajamas on.
Bruh.
I paid $14,000 for these seats. She come back, man. Excuse me, sir. There's no more seats on the plane.
Mm.
They told me, and the pilot at this point is like, you know, everybody needs to buckle up.
Oh,
and she's like, sir,
man.
I need to sit down. I go find a flight attendant, and I go out and say, ma'am, there's a lady saying that she's in this seat. Y'all told me we get the whole row. I said, somebody in my seat in first class. My seat in first class. And she's like, sir, we have to get ready and take off. You need to sit down. And then now while I'm over there talking to the lady, the older lady, she slipperoo, a switcheroo, and she come and hurry up and sit down.
Oh, no doubt.
Dang.
And then she don't sit down in the middle. She sit down on the end. So now I'm stuck in the middle. I'm claustrophobic. So now I'm in the middle the whole
You know what's crazy? Like I felt good flying because, and I ain't had my Wi-Fi or nothing on, but I felt good flying because the last I talked to Marl, he said, yo, I ain't get first, but I did get the whole row, me and Camille. So I'm
you
good.
On there
so
I was worked out.
So I felt while I was flying all the way to the States in the lab of luxury, I said, my homie ain't flying first, but at least he got the
whole row.
Him
and Candace, they pouring champagne.
Oh, well.
They over there, me and Camille. Just hurt.
Good thing though, it was Italy. That's where y'all were?
Yeah, wrong.
Good thing. Because that's only like what?
8 hours.
It wasn't like Dubai.
No. Oh, I would have jumped off the plane, bro. I couldn't do it. I would have jumped off the plane. Whew, 16 hours. Man.
I'm saying not even Delta Comfort.
I ain't never really been in Delta Comfort.
They didn't even give me,
Delta
they tried Comfort's to bring me a meal. They tried to bring me the little meal, man. I was like, man, get this. Man, I was heated, bro.
Oh, yeah. Marl had a little beef with Delta.
I was done with Delta.
You should have been. Yeah. Don't ever let it happen again.
Let me tell you something. If you
I got you.
Next time I want to see you fly Frontier over there.
I ain't never even been in Frontier.
Oh, bro. Frontier is a wild place.
What's the one we used to call EasyJet?
Oh.
EasyJet.
Easy. We flew EasyJet in Poland. We was in Poland.
I've never heard of EasyJet.
Oh, let me tell you something. We in Poland, bro. And so he told me, he said, yeah, you know, it's EasyJet, but remember he said, at least we're in first class.
We had one A, B, C,
one A,
D, or whatever.
Yeah, one A, one B, one C, one D.
Feel me, Ma?
We good.
I was like, yo,
it's right.
We got first class. I ain't tripping. I mean, it's a whack plane, but we got first class.
Yeah.
Okay, so there was no first class. And not only was it not first class, they board and deplane out the back of the plane.
Yeah.
So we end up being in the first row, which is the last row, because they're using the door at the back of the plane. So we literally in the very, bro, it was.
1A, more, I didn't know. 1A.
Bro. Yeah, and we said, it's easy, Jet, where you could do this.
The easy way?
Or the hard
And we did it the hard
way. It was the longest hour flight I've ever had in my life.
And then remember we land, let me tell you something.
Seats were
terrible. Seen E. That was one of your worst moments, because we landed, and remember we had about 3 hours in customs in London.
Oh.
And you know E don't do lines and just waiting like that. I felt so bad. You know, E will usually just go cut the whole line. Like,
yeah, no, that was bad. That's probably the worst I've seen.
Worst ever.
That was bad.
Oh, no, bro.
Yeah, that was
It was like a legit 3 hours, bro.
Yeah.
Imagine, our sleep schedule off time.
London.
We on a tour, world tour.
Yeah.
We was on a world tour.
Yeah, we left from Poland and went over to
Never let London. Nobody, this is a lesson. Never let nobody book your flights for you who have a poverty mindset. Because they putting you in poverty seating.
EasyJet.
Bro. And look.
You know I got a picture.
And here's the thing, though. It's other people that was with us, they didn't take that flight.
Nope.
And do all of that.
Nope. They were on the same tour.
And I learned, like, nope, don't let people, nothing disrespectful, but like, I done had Rondell get some paint. He done bought the paint.
Yep.
Even though I got bread, he done bought the paint. That he would buy.
He would buy, yep.
And I'm like, bro, I can see through, I can see that
it
was yellow. You
gotta put 10 coats on it.
You know, or he bought me fixtures, and they were all inferior fixtures. So I'm like, yeah, I'm being real. Don't let nobody buy you no ticket who don't believe in not waiting 3 hours. And the lady who bought it for me, did she go with us, or did she fly differently? I don't even remember. I don't even know if she flew with us.
She didn't even fly.
Yeah.
I don't remember her being, she went with us. I think she met us at the airport, but I don't think she was on our flight. Yeah. That's what I remember. Yes.
That's the problem.
Right. You got it?
Yeah. Let me see. You got it. Bring it to, let me get it, because you're too close.
Oh! he does. How you find that? What year was that?
Let me. I got to do it from my phone.
This
you
was too close. 2016.
Wow.
Oh, well, we could do this. That's what Diddy said. He was looking like Easy Jet.
Wow.
Bruh, Easy Jet. I took a picture of E. We, oh, bruh. Yep. Go and put that
That's
up on the
crazy.
Pod.
Yeah. Send it to me. Send it to me.
Oh, man.
Easy Jet.
Oh, I sent it to the podcast. Group chat. All right.
Uh-oh.
What? Flight delay?
Got a notification.
No. I'm waiting on 360. I don't care nothing about that delay.
Travel alert.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Travel alert in effect for Chicago Grand Rapids.
I still say on time. Okay. All right. Well, so, man, E, I wanted to get back to something that you said. You were talking about at Forward, your sermon, you know, not using the word backwards, using the word reverse, and that all your, basically your curses in the past and your blessings in the present, in the future, I'm sorry, and living towards the future. If you can give us just a recap so we can get into that, because that was powerful, bro.
I would hate to maul on the last episode, really went there on the positive part in terms of the forward part, you know, the future part. And what's so crazy too, man, that's why I tell y'all, you have to be very careful who you hang with and who you spend time with, you know. I guess it was last week, you know, when Carl was talking about the census and how stuff goes into it. Like, you cannot underestimate that. And I think we have it in reverse. I think what we do is we honor relationships more than we honor census. You feel me? And that's why a lot of us are not where we need to be. So we would allow people to use our senses in a way that's not healthy just to stay in healthy relationships with them, even though they're not healthy for us.
Mm.
You feel me? As opposed to going scientifically and saying, if it's not good for me, then I shouldn't. But it's relationships. None of us in this room would allow somebody to bring in some antifreeze and pour it into our cup and say, because we homies, drink this antifreeze.
Mm. Mm.
It's antifreeze, bro. So you wouldn't drink antifreeze because you know what it would do to its poison.
Mm-hmm.
But what we do, because we have relationships with people, we allow them to be antifreeze just because we got a relationship with them.
Wow.
But it's still antifreeze, though. Like, just because it's your sibling or your parent or your homie, it's still antifreeze.
Yep.
You know. And so one of the things that I realize is I just have to be cautious about, you know, the antifreeze. Right. And so when I was talking about backwards, I was really talking about backwards and what it does to your psyche, like what it does to you as a human. Like, backwards, as soon as you go backwards, that's it. Like you're done. You're through. Like, when Maul was talking about forward, okay, yeah. That's why he's saying be in the forward, because in the forward, you unleashing, we talked about, we unlock. But as soon as you go to the back. We talked about Maul was disgusted being in the back of the plane, bro. He was disgusted being, because they don't treat you the same way in the front of the plane, in the way, they don't make you a priority when you're in the back. They make you a priority when you're sitting up front.
Yeah.
And a lot of times people be tripping on first class. Like, bro, it has nothing to do with just the seat. It is a different culture and environment. I just got on the first class plane going to Huntsville. Bro, I don't even know these dudes. We had a family reunion in the front that quick. One dude was from Saudi Arabia, but he was originally from UK. Another dude was from Huntsville. He living in Saudi Arabia. Bruh, am I saying it right? Yeah, Saudi Arabia.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what, yeah. Bruh, they going back and forth and they talking about dope. They like, we listen to your stuff. Bruh, the lady heard, she know my boy Buddy from Oakwood. Bruh, it was I'm talking about, we had a phenomenal experience. It was
meanwhile, coach, sit your down. Yeah.
It was, see,
don't touch.
It was a short flight. It was a short flight. Okay, so
that's the inside thing.
And my wife said, My wife said,
it was a short flight.
My wife was like, whoa, this was a short flight.
Oh, short flight.
So you know it was a short flight.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't say
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Didi was like, it was a short flight.
Oh, yeah.
So by the grace of God.
Ain't been a whole lot of short flights lately, though.
I don't know.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Carl, this must be 360.
Yeah.
I was going to say, y'all going to let us in? Or y'all
no, no,
just,
no.
Once
it go off. Once the cameras go off.
I'm talking 360.
Yeah. We don't want everybody to know.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But bruh, what I was saying, Maul, is that there are humans that literally get up. Let's just say, for instance, you know, Korshawn. I know one of my homies that was incarcerated. I promise you, he'd wake up. And he'll talk about being incarcerated.
Mm.
And I'll watch him, like, as he's moving around people, treat himself a certain way because he's feeling like, I'm like, first of all, they don't even know you were incarcerated.
Right.
It's in his head. They don't even know you incarcerated. But I watch him walk around like, yo, if they find out, if they whatever. And I'm like, bruh, you are literally living not only in the past, but you are reliving your sentence, cause you in the past.
Yeah.
So you're literally reliving it.
You're still in there.
You're still in there, bro. Like you may not physically still be in there, but you're still in there. So what I was trying to teach the group was, hey y'all, do me a huge favor. The Lord bless. That's why I said, be careful who you hang with. CJ just said one day, I was like, see, bro, Atlanta is faith. I don't know why I'm going. I don't get it. Yep. I don't understand it. So he was like, all right, call it forward. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. I'm not really sure what that means, but cool. Yeah. And as I was doing it, I started catching up to the future.
Mm. CJ name? You came
yeah, he came up with the name forward.
Huh.
And so.
See if that's enough to give me the 360.
We're working on it. We're working on it.
I'm not trying to go backwards.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're working on
no.
it. You know? And so.
I'm about going forward. You
know it was weird, Ma. Maybe fourth, fifth visit, it was like, ooh, forward.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I got
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, I see what God is saying. Most of us will never be what God would have us to be because we're not going forward.
Yep.
We're going backwards. Yep. You feel me? And so what I was trying to explain to them is, and your senses don't go back.
Yeah.
So I was looking at every time in my marriage, I got caught in my feelings, our marriage wouldn't be great.
Mm.
So it was like, yo, you've been able to go without arguing. Now, I'm not going to lie and say my wife and I are shrinking because we're not arguing. We're not shrinking, but it's not getting emotional.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, bro, it's not that deep. Like, you feel that way, I feel this way. All right, I'm going to compromise, you know, because most of the time, Didi want to have things her way. She's a pilot. So it's like, in her brain, she feel like, you got to go this way. And I'm like, well, it's really three ways to go. But before, I used to get into it with her because I'm like, yo, I want to go this way. Nah, it's like, okay, it's the marriage. Why would you go this way and argue when you can just go this way and be at peace? Like, you ain't going to save but 5 minutes going this way. You could go 496 and get 96, or you can just go all the way around 96. I prefer to go straight through the city.
Oh, yeah, Didi, yeah, me too.
That all day.
I hate going all that.
Didi went to work on Cedar, so it was 96.
So she know that.
So that's her whole hookup. So I used to be like, I'm going to go through. So now we're spending 5-10 minutes on. Now I'm just like, 96. Save myself, you know, whatever. But I'm trying to tell you, I know now, if you go back to that, you got to have your way, or you're pissed because she got to always have her way. That's backwards. So y'all might end up getting into it, and it might last an hour, it might last three, and now the synergy ain't there over 96 or 496. Like, it's dumb. So, it don't make sense. So everything backwards, you know, whatever it is that's backwards, like, E, don't go back there. Why? Because you don't live there. Mm-hmm. You're not there. But the way the human brain works, Carl said you could close your eyes and see in pictures. Oh. You could see in old pictures if you're not
100%.
Careful. 100%. You can see it old pictures, bruh. So instead of seeing it in the future, see it in color, you living in black and white.
Mm.
You feel me? And every time you go back, it is what it is. It's back. So there's no nutrients there. There's nothing healthy there because you don't belong there.
Yeah.
Like, you don't belong in 98, 2000.
You know what was funny too, E? Like, I don't even know if I told you this, but when you kept saying backwards, like, I wasn't only thinking of going backwards. I was thinking of backwards thinking.
Yep, that's good.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
So when you were talking about Samson and, you know, getting his hair cut and, like, the fact that he kept doing it, right? Like, the first day, he's like, you know what I'm saying? My man was like, oh, yeah, y'all almost took me out. You know what I'm saying? He defeated him. Then you got her back. It wasn't just backwards. Like, when you kept saying it, I was like, oh, that's not backwards just in terms of, like, going back. That's backwards thinking. Like, you would think that, all right, cool, homegirl tried to take me out. This next day, I'm going, I don't care how good everything else was. You try to
kill me.
It ain't just about going backwards. It makes you backwards think. Does that make sense?
Like, no question.
I don't know if you was trying to say that, but that's how I ended up taking it when you was talking about
Samson. Well, that's going to be my next sermon then.
You see what I'm saying?
No question.
So you just thinking, I used to be an addict and now I'm backwards going back. Like, I'm physically, you kind of picture physically going backwards. I was thinking kind of like crazy as in backwards. Like, your thinking is backwards.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And so.
No, and I want to say this to that point, and that's why it's dangerous when you go back. Because when you go back, not only are you back and you're not useful, you're back and the people that are forward, y'all at odds now.
Mm. Oh, for sure.
You feel me? Like, you at odds with forward-thinking people. You feel what I'm saying? So now, if I'm in the room with the three of y'all and I'm, like you just said, 360. If you were backwards thinking, it would have just been like, oh, I didn't get 360, I'm out. But because you're forward thinking, you thinking, yo, how do I reinstate my status?
Yep.
Well, you in a room with somebody that has, that relationships is my thing, so I got red coats that I know there.
That's when relationships be beating me. You know what I'm
saying? No question.
I can't go on nobody.
But that's my job, though. That's my job in the crew, is to make sure that I keep.
Yeah, of course.
So I thought, oh, Lloyd came to church. Like, we went from chopping it up at the Sky Club to now, Lloyd coming to church and him hit me on my phone and we just kicking it. Mm. So because you're not backwards, you're forward. Now you can use my forward for your forward. Mm. Same thing with Maul. I was backwards with houses. I was backwards with real estate.
Yeah.
I was backwards thinking because I was talking to backwards people when it comes to that.
Yeah.
So then when I get with Maul, it didn't work when I first got with Maul, because even though I was with Maul, I was backwards thinking, so I couldn't enjoy the forward thinker.
Mm.
Does that make sense? Like, 100%. I couldn't enjoy that. So not only are you backwards and backwards thinking, hurting yourself, but you're not even able to tap into the environment that you're in because you're backwards.
And I'm going to make it super simple. When you're driving and you look to the right, what happens?
You veer to the right.
When you look to the left, what happens?
Yeah, you veer to the
left. It's not just backward that's the problem.
Yeah.
Mm. It's not just backward. Yeah. If it's not forward, it's a problem.
Period.
Yeah,
you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, if it's wrong forward.
Bruh, you could be going this way. And I'm talking about if you just, and that's what's so deep about your senses. If you just look, your body now follows where you're going. You see what I'm saying? Wherever if you look just good. Look.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, be careful with that, because any other direction is not where you're trying to go.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to this show, please, I begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.